Okay, welcome once again to MBAbullshit.com. So our topic for this video is the present value of an annuity. Okay? So remember, you can always go back to MBAbullshit.com. Now, before this video, you should already understand present value and net present value. If you don't understand it yet, you can watch my other free videos on these topics above. Alright, so let's get down to it. Okay, let's start with a question. What if bank deposit rates outside, also known as a discount rate, maybe, are now at 5% per year or per annum? Okay, per annum means per year. And what if someone offered you a sure investment which would give you $100 in the first year, $100 in the second year, and $100 in the third year? Okay, so each payment is equal to each other and it is for a set number of years, exactly 3 years. Now, how much is this investment worth? Okay, well, we already know from the present value and net present value formulas that the investment is worth 100 multiplied by 1.05, meaning 5%, raised to the negative 1 for year 1, and raised to the negative 2 for year 2, raised to the negative 3 for year 3. And we will find that this investment, using the net present value formula, is $272.33. Okay? So, this investment is called an annuity. Alright? It has equal payments every period, and it's usually every year, and it is set for a certain number of years or a certain number of periods. Okay? It is not forever. Okay, now this $272.33 over here is called the present value of an annuity. Okay, so it's simple. Okay, but it was simple because it was only three payments. What if it happened to be a lot more than 3 years, like maybe 32 years? Okay, it would be too long, alright? It would be too long to use the present value formula for each payment, okay? Imagine if we had to write down this plus this plus this for 32 years all the way there and continuing, okay? That would take way too long. So luckily, we have a shortcut formula, and it looks like this. Oh, a scary formula, right? Look at it. It looks really freaky. Alright? Now, there's actually an even scarier version than this. Okay? Your professor might use a different formula than this, but it's still the same as this. As long as he says it's the present value of an annuity formula, it's actually the same as this, but it might be even longer. Okay? Or crazier, but mathematically it will be the same. Now, okay, here's an even easier one which I use, which I pretty much, I don't know, I don't think I invented it. I'm sure somebody else also made it, but here's an easier one which I use. Alright, now don't panic, it still looks scary, but it's actually much easier to do when you use a calculator or a scientific calculator, and it looks like this. Whoa, what's this? Alright? Now the first thing I want you to remember is that this X over here and this X over here means multiplication, okay? It is not a variable, okay? It is not the variable X. It just means 1 times R, or 1 multiplied by R. Same thing here. It means 1 multiplied by R. Okay, so if we do that, okay, if we use this formula, it becomes easy as pie. And let me show you. Okay, so based on the earlier example, the present value of our annuity is $100, okay, which is the cash payment or cash flow over here, multiplied by 1, which is given in the formula, multiplied by the rate of the bank or the discount rate, which is 5% or 0.05, raised to the negative 1, which is given, minus, okay, again 1, which is given, multiplied by 0.05, which is the rate over here, raised to the negative 1, which is also given, multiplied by 1 plus R, which is the same as 1.05, okay? Why? 0.05 is the interest rate of 5%. Raised to the negative N, or the negative number of years. And I already said it was 32 years. So raised to the negative 32. And if we do this all together, we multiply this whole thing and put a subtraction over here, okay, on your calculator, we will get the amount of $1,580. So now you know the present value of an annuity. Okay, now a note is that if your calculator sucks, okay, if your calculator sucks, then you cannot do a negative exponent like this. And so you will have to do it the long way using this. Now, I highly recommend you get a good scientific calculator. It is not an expense, it is a good investment. All right? So get a good scientific calculator which can do negative exponent signs like this. And then you'll be able to compute this thing over here in a jiffy. All right? So there you have it, the present value of an annuity. Now that you understand the basic concept of present value of an annuity, you are ready for our next video on present value of a growing annuity, and also other annuity problems such as delayed annuity, an annuity due, infrequent annuity, comparison of annuities, etc. And you can find those on MBAbullshit.com. Alright, so for this video, I hope you liked it. Please share it. And on Twitter, you can follow us. Our nickname is MBAbullshit. On Facebook, just type in our website in the search box and you'll find our fan page. And please do become a fan so you can receive updates and new videos, and forward our YouTube link on your email. Have a great day and goodbye.